Dear Muriel, I wanted to share with you and your friends a few memorable moments in our siblinghood together, as you have fulfilled your working obligations and can now enjoy retirement. You've always been a trooper, thought outside the box, worked hard, and raised a beautiful family of adventurous, interesting, and unique individuals. I would like to celebrate the part of your life that has made you the adventurous, interesting, and unique individual you are. You were born in San Francisco, Chinatown in 1940, at a time when the war had just started. Hitler had taken over Poland the year before, and on April 9th, the Nazis invaded Denmark and Norway. The following month, they captured France, Belgium, Luxembourg, and the Netherlands, and Winston Churchill became British Prime Minister. Although I wasn't around yet, you and our three sisters were already born. I can't speak much for the time before I existed, but I understand that you lived frugally but happily in a small one-room apartment on Sacramento Street. Here you are in a pensive moment contemplating the meaning of life, or was it just being abandoned by others on the schoolyard? Typically, you were surrounded by plenty of playmates with opportunities to get yourself into trouble. Here's the entire family in San Francisco. Eventually, our family moved to the East Bay. Here's the Fong family quartet in front of our new home in West Oakland. Then I arrived. Sister Frances couldn't hack the thought, and you weren't too sure whether you were getting a good deal after being the youngest for 8 years. Despite being your bratty little sister, I was your playmate and you were mine. I never noticed whether it was a burden to you or not, but I'm sure it wasn't much fun lugging me around, but y'all got to job share. We moved to 8th Avenue, and this is a rare shot with you and me, Joanne, our sister, and Mommy. This reminds me of the wonderful times we had together, searching for 7-Up bottle caps in the gutter to get into movies free at the Parkway Theater, walking to the library, and going grocery shopping at Lucky's. You took care of me after school while Mommy worked in the sewing factory and cooked dinner for all of us. Here's your high school graduation photo. After graduating from Oakland High and leaving your numerous friends, you began working at Kaiser Center. I always remember that you were able to type at 80 or 90 words per minute and take shorthand like greased lightning. Here's a working girl photo of you in front of Maryland's 57 Chevy. One of your friends there had just returned from the Foreign Service, and she gave you the idea that meant disaster for me. You applied and successfully qualified for the USIS as a Foreign Service Secretary. On return from the USIS and a trip by freighter around the world, you met Rod and settled down. Soon you got hitched, and before long, Matt arrived, then Amy, then Barry. They were very adorable kids, and I admired your ability to work and manage a sizable family at the same time. Your selflessness and devotion to them are truly remarkable and exemplary. You were a great mom and a great role model for me. After living in Oakland, then Walnut Creek, and back to Oakland for a stint, you and Rod decided to move to Portland, where a big opportunity was waiting for Rod and better schools were now attainable for the kids. After that, you moved to Lake Tahoe, where the kids got a lot of exposure to the healthy outdoor living that you each continue to enjoy today. In the meantime, the rest of us were all busy working and raising families. Here's a shot at the time of the five of us and Mom. Well, it didn't seem to hold you for very long. As each of your children grew up and went their separate ways or got married, you found an excellent exit strategy. You worked very tenaciously to rejoin the Foreign Service and successfully applied and qualified again. This time I was better prepared for your departure. It was another exciting chapter of your life about to unfold. Your first post in Beijing was very exciting for you and for those of us who were able to visit you there. You got to meet Madeleine Albright and went to North Korea on a special mission. It was a busy and glamorous time of your life. You learned enough Chinese to get around the city, find the best bargains, know the back streets for food and custom-made clothing, and even had the benefit of the local outdoor bazaar and one of the first Starbucks in China right outside your door. As if that wasn't enough excitement, you went for a second tour. This time you were posted to Tegucigalpa, Honduras. Quite a switch from China, but I'm sure the language was much easier to master in a short time. Muriel, you have been my mentor and an inspiration to me. My love of traveling was generated by your courage and determination to venture out and see and experience the world firsthand. I'm so glad you did, and you were able to strongly influence and impact our lives in such a positive way. I'm truly grateful to you for what you've done for me and how I was able to pass this love of travel to my family. But it goes much further beyond the traveling. On top of all this, you took excellent care of our dear mother for 2 years until her end of life. Your dedication to your family and your compassion and readiness to share with others have all directed me to lead a better life. I know you will continue to inspire your family and others in whatever you do and in your future endeavors, whether they are close to home or another future far-flung place. I know you're looking forward to this personal time and a chance to savor the wonderful life ahead for you. You have earned it, and I'm proud of everything you've done to make life richer and more fulfilling for the rest of us. I love you, and thank you for being who you are. Love, Vicky.
Stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more.